Tambo is the same as many other livestock farmers around the world. He loves his cattle because they have both commercial and cultural value. When talking about the importance of cattle, we have been living with cattle from the very beginning. We have a long association and a rich culture because cattle are the basis of our cuisine, our songs and dances, and even our clothing. In former times, our ancestors were herding cattle. In recent times, we stopped herding cattle, and that's when we noticed land degradation taking place. Perennial grasses have disappeared, only a few remain. And now we have this problem of poor grasslands and serious soil erosion. We say last year was a good rainy season, and now we are complaining that this year is drought. Where is the perennial grasses from last year? Where is that good grass now? That shows us that we don't manage our land or our grasses, and now they have disappeared. Living and working with livestock is getting harder and harder. That's why farmers and government are coming together from all over Namibia to find out why our grasses are disappearing and what we can do to bring them back. All over Namibia, farmers are calling out. They have witnessed huge changes going on around them, including the disappearance of their perennial grasses within their own lifetime.
In the past 35 years, we had at least five severe droughts that at some times I didn't know how we're going to survive the next year. And you can see, you can look around, it's one of those years at the moment.
Many small animals and insects have disappeared from this area. Important animals in the food chain, like the scaly anteater, have completely died out. Bullfrogs, hedgehogs, porcupines, and tortoises, you don't see them anymore. As a young boy, when we started farming here, every 100 meters you could find a beehive full of honey. Because perennial grasses and flowering plants have died out, you won't find a single honeybee on this whole 13,000-hectare farm. When I was young, the perennial grasses here was this high. This is the place we would collect grass thatch for our houses. But today you cannot find any grass for your roof. Animals here used to eat well. Now they are hungry. There is no grazing left here. The commercial farming system doesn't help you at all if you have no grazing. How do you implement a system when there is no grazing? It's impossible. Farmers all over Namibia are witnessing serious environmental changes going on around them. Grasses are disappearing. Soils are becoming hard and cracked, and erosion is washing and blowing away the topsoil, until all that is left is a brittle, barren and broken landscape.
This is the end result of bad management. This has been here for years. I remember it when I was a boy, because I was grown up 5 kilometers in a village called Krosave, and once I'm coming here with the goats, this was smaller than what it is here. But we can see here now today. It starts from no grass, and then the capping, and then the water came and washed all the surface of this area.
All these farmers are concerned about the lack of grazing. Most think it is because of less and less rain, or that there are too many boreholes or too many people, or that bush encroachment has taken over their best pastures. None of these, though, are the root cause. The real problem is we are not giving our grass plants what they need. Given time and the right rangeland management techniques, sweet grasses do return, and even dried up springs will flow again. In Namibia, we are beginning to shift the focus from our animals to our pastures. The first question we must ask ourselves is, what is it that a grass plant needs to be healthy? Because if we have healthy grasses, then we will have healthy cattle, even in the driest years. Otherwise,
the whole of Kauko will end up like this if we have bad management. We will see the whole of Kauko looking like this. It's not a good result.
Farmers in the Kunene region are putting their heads together to find out what the problem is and how to resolve it. We began to wonder, and we asked ourselves, what happened to the perennial grasses? Why have the perennial grasses disappeared? In earlier times, our ancestors were herding their cattle so they could not be killed by predators like lions. When we got boreholes, we stopped herding. That was the time all the grasses started disappearing. When we started the holistic range management program in this area, it took us back to the times of our forefathers, and we started to realize we are the ones that killed our grasses because we are not taking care of them. Now, these farmers have decided that the best way to bring back perennial grasses is to revive some of the old ways of herding. That's why we are saying this holistic range management program is not new to us. This is what our forefathers did. They were herding their cattle and they received special status because they could bring home all the cattle each night. They would also rotate their cattle, moving with the seasons to different pastures. Our generation stopped the old way of herding and the migration of big herds to seasonal grazing areas. The cattle just roam freely now. There is no herding. Left to roam freely, cattle will always follow one another in single file. Their hooves erode deep paths that turn into rivers in the wet season. When everyone's cattle are wandering everywhere freely and the grasses do not get what they need, they are either overgrazed or undergrazed, and they die. All over Namibia, what is left today are grasslands without any topsoil or perennial grasses. Once fertile valleys are now suffocating with thorny plants and incised with deep dongas. These farmers have decided to return to some of their old ways of herding to better manage their grasses, soils, and water points. Within the holistic range management program, farmers are bringing together their cattle into one big herd. The hooves of these hundreds of cattle mimic the vast wildlife herds that used to migrate seasonally all across Southern Africa. As they move across the landscape, they break up the ground, soften the soil, mix in manure, trample in new seeds, till and aerate the ground, and increase the amount of water going into the soil. All this prepares the soil for the onset of the rains and stimulates grass growth. By herding one big herd to seasonal pastures, these farmers are mimicking nature and improving the effective rainfall in the soil. Even in badly degraded land, where no grasses will grow, farmers are herding their cattle now to give grass plants exactly what they need. Not only to survive, but to flourish and spread. Where there are no grasses left, the topsoil becomes very hard and kept, too hard for the seeds to penetrate the ground and to grow. So we make sure to trample the hard topsoil. So when it rains, the water and the seeds go underground and grasses grow well. Farmers have learned that it is important to graze their herd in the right way at the right time. It is important to herd intensively in the dry season, to trample the old grass to make a ground cover. So when it rains, it limits the runoff of rainwater and gives water a chance to penetrate. Ground cover keeps soil moist, so when it does rain, plants can grow well. Because we made sure the soil was covered with grass at the end of the dry season, the little rain that we did receive this year went underground and the grass grew well enough, even though there wasn't a lot of rain. In the non-growing season, our dry season, farmers should use their animals as a powerful tool to put the right impact on the land, to prepare the soil for the onset of the rains. Cattle are a powerful tool that farmers can use to break up hard surfaces and dam up erosion trails and dongas made by cattle using the same route day after day. We can drive cattle across this path to stop them becoming streams when it rains. As well as healing the land, herding stimulates biodiversity. Animals, birds, insects all start to work together again. You can see the land coming back to life. The rainy season is potentially the most dangerous time for grass plants. As we have heard already, it is not uncommon to hear people say, in our area, the grass used to be this high. All over Namibia, grasses have disappeared because during the wet season, these plants are eaten again and again. They have no time to recover and grow, and the plant dies. That's why Mutambo says, we are the ones that actually killed our own plants. Herding needs to work according to a grazing plan. These farmers herd their livestock along a different route each day to give individual grass plants exactly what they need to grow well in the wet season, good soil cover and adequate recovery time. When pastures have fully recovered, that's when we come back. We have to give time for photosynthesis and replenishment of the root systems.
The grass here has been nicely grazed when the material has been taken off, which means the photosynthesis will take place very nicely here. This is what we all are looking forward to.
During the growing season, we want all perennial grasses to be big and healthy like this one, with strong roots that bind the soil together. The key element of good grazing is to combine livestock into big herds around a single water point. These farmers have developed a grazing pattern that combines their traditional skills of herding with the modern science of grasses. By moving big herds backwards and forwards along different routes across the landscape, herders are giving individual grass plants the right impact at the right interval. Moving to seasonal pastures stimulates individual plants and entire regional grasslands to become stronger. These farmers study the changing condition of their grass plants to decide exactly when to move their herd. They take into account the additional complexity of nature here, that it can be 2 months or it can be 2 years before grasses recover, depending on the rain. I don't think anyone expected that our annual grasses would be growing so well again, or that the perennial grasses that were lost here have started to re-establish themselves. If you look around here, you will see many young perennial grass plants. What we are doing here is very important. We are using our cattle to heal our land. These farmers will be the first to admit, though, that to get where they are today has not been easy. They have had to negotiate and get permissions from their traditional authorities and from government ministries. And they have had to put up major infrastructures in some of the most inhospitable regions of Namibia.
I do believe that we should take the grazing management system that has newly been introduced by the IRDNC by its horns and manage our grazing, because then it is going to benefit our animals, it is going to benefit our wildlife, it is going to benefit our children, and then most importantly, it will boost the tourism, because we have got what it needs to draw tourists into our area.
Farmers are using their conservancies as decision-making structures for this holistic range management program. Conservancies have traditionally been used for planning wildlife and tourism. They are now establishing smaller units within conservancies at the farmer level to decide what infrastructure is needed and where to put it. The other challenge has been for all farmers to work together about a single water point to properly manage communal grasslands. This is working because these areas have never been fenced off and allows for large herds to be herded according to a regional grazing plan. Farmers in northwest Namibia became famous in the 1980s and 90s for pioneering the CBNRM program in Namibia. Today, these farmers and their conservancies are now focusing their attention on the conservation of grass plants and improving biodiversity of grasslands. This will not only benefit livestock, but also wildlife, conservation and tourism throughout the region. Just like the CBNRM program, Namibia prides itself on going beyond best practices. We are leapfrogging and learning from what others call best practice. Getting perennial grasses back is a local, regional, and international challenge. These efforts in the Northwest are an attempt to learn from the old and the new worlds. Driving 1,200 head of cattle across the landscape gives the right animal impact at the right time. Herding and plant grazing is an age-old technology that is challenging fences. These are proving to be a better management tool at a lower cost for communal farmers, resettlement farms, and even on privately owned farms. Herding and plant grazing is the best tool we have for the future to bring back our perennial grasses and to continue to make a living with livestock. If land degradation continues the way it has been going, it will mean the end of us as a tribe, because we Himba live from our cattle and cattle live from grass. And once the grass is gone, then the cattle are gone and we will also be gone. If we manage our land well, we will not only survive, but prosper. One day, all Namibian farmers will say, "I'm not so much a cattle farmer, I am a grass farmer." We are realizing that cattle are the major catalyst of change, and herders are the heroes to do it. We are putting the herd and the herder back into the center of livestock farming where they belong. By praising the shepherd, we are answering the call. We are bringing back what everyone else is busy losing, our precious grasslands.